What's going on, everybody? This is Lemon Drop 14E here with the first of the Forza Longplays that I'm going to be doing. Now, what a Forza Longplay is, it's a long race that I do on Forza, and that's about it. It can be any car, any class, anything, but today we've got NASCARs at Road America, 15 laps, 2 quick stops, and that's it. So let's get the race started. Now, as you guys can see, we've got a rolling start, and it's manual shifting is what I'm going to be doing here. And this is my custom done PPG paint job. I say custom because I painted it. I did not do the logos, but whatever. So here we go. First corner at Road America. Going to be kind of a crapshoot, so I'm going to hang back a little bit. Don't really see the need to demolish the car in the first corner. You know, sort of like that. Looking at my RPMs and did not pay any attention, so that's fun. Let's get up here, get around Matthew. Now, you guys probably... okay. I'm going to be referring to these drivers as the NASCAR paint jobs, because I don't actually know who these people are, but... I'm going to get under Matt here and see if we can chase down Carl. How bad does the front end look? I will check in a second. Not too bad. I didn't see any damage popping up, so... It is on simulation damage, so that's fun. So, I mean, tires and fuel were... They probably won't come into play just because it's such a short track. Or a short race, rather. It's only 15 laps. But, whoa, we've got some contact up here. Danny's going to dive in behind me, so it's cool. Man, so I'm not sure how much tires and stuff are going to come into play. I plan on using pit strategies best I can, just because there is 2 stops required. So I'm not sure when I'll take those 2 stops. I didn't do any practice or anything here, so I'm not sure when tires start to fall off, etc. So, as you guys can see, I do have traction control on, just because, I don't know, I like to race that way. I don't have stability on, or, anti-lock brakes on. Come on now. Kinda got a roadblock in front of me. Between old, man. Getting on the brakes hard, these guys are. Yeah. Kenseth, or Harvick rather, just going backwards. Locked up a little bit. Make that outside work. You can kinda see where the traffic's starting to thin out. Where, the faster cars are getting past. Try to make this outside work. There we go. Up on Kyle Larson and got around him clean. That was pretty good little exchange there. But anyway, I was trying to figure out when would be the best time to pit. So if we look at my tires, we're already at, we're already at basically 3% all the way around. And I think if I recall correctly, you can start really telling a difference at about 10%. Maybe a little more, I don't know. But anyway, about 10%, so that's looking at about 3 laps, I'll call it, until the steering might go away a little bit. So not... So ideally we'd have, five stops just to keep fresh tires on it. Obviously that's not really an option when there's no yellow flags, so we have to play this like it's going to be a green flag pit stop every time, because it is. Slide job around the outside. Yeah, I knew that wouldn't work out too well for me. Someone else locking him up. Looks like Joey up there is. Ah, shifted too early. Yeah, so basically we're just going to try and play this like it would be green flag stops. Like I just said. Trying to get under Carl. I'm here, bub. Trying to shut the door on me, and I guess he will, because I don't want to run the outside here. See if I can't encourage him out of the way. Yeah, I put him in the dirt pretty good there. Was not the plan, you know. Doesn't matter, no yellow flags or nothing, so... Just gonna keep cruising like nothing happened. Now, right, this exchange through the track here is where I think I can really make up some time. Computer seems to like to stand on the brakes a little bit there, and I don't. If you're wondering, they're on expert difficulty, so take that for what it's worth. I don't know if I'm going to win this race just because it's been a long time since I played Forza, so it's kind of putting on an old shoe. It fits all right. You kind of get used to it again pretty soon, but hopefully the laps won't be gone before I get completely used to it. Let's take a look at the fuel. 85%, so we're going to look at... What's it going to be? When I cross the lines, 84. So we lost 16% in two complete laps. So basically 8% a lap. So in 10 laps, that'd be 80% gone. So we'd have 20%. So yeah, we wouldn't be able to make it on fuel anyway, just straight through. So fuel mileage is not going to be an issue. Yeah. If it was just one quick stop, I would probably go... I'd probably pit as early as possible. Or did I do it as late as possible? Ooh, I don't know. Doesn't matter if it's two, because that kind of screws that plan up. That Doritos bag is leading. I'm not sure what kind of times he's laying down. Nope, not a good one this lap. Wow, followed each other off. He's going to come door me. Nope, perfect. Well, that couldn't have went better, actually. If I can put some ground between me and the two guys behind me, I might go ahead and make one of my stops, and then just make a late stop. Ooh, I don't know. I usually don't like to make a late stop just because I don't like getting chased down when I'm on pit road. I like to be the one chasing if that's possible, you know. But we'll see. Now, yeah, I'm really putting some distance between us, so I don't know. Maybe expert mode's not high enough. I'm not real sure. I know the faster and crazier the cars get, I'm usually not very good, like in exotic cars or Formula One, God forbid. So I feel like I'm comfortable in a NASCAR. So normally, I think I'll leave it on expert just because it's a track I'm familiar with. And cars that I'm really familiar with, I think I can get away with that. Yep. So yeah, this next lap, I'm just gonna hit my marks, come in. Obviously, we'll get four fresh and topping off the fuel. Yeah, so we're getting at about 10% on our tires now. Ooh, a little more there, so I locked them up. Cut that one a little bit shy. It's okay, it didn't gonna hurt nothing. Didn't even make the lap, not count. Didn't mean to take the high side there, but I did, so that's fine.
We'll make it
work. So obviously, just by nature, these long plays are gonna be longer videos, so I guess I don't need to explain why they're long races, so I guess I don't. Even though I just did, I don't know. Drive with the throttle a little bit there. Yeah, I'll take that. Probably could have shifted up a little bit sooner, but it's holding the line pretty good, so I don't want to screw that up. If you guys would prefer in-car view, I can do that too. Typically, is what I was going to say there, is I would do standard, but since I'm in the NASCAR, since I'm in a pit, I'll just alternate, you know, on pit stops, you know, just to mix it up a little bit. But let's see. Had 1,300 feet on them coming in. I don't think they're going to pit here. Nah. They're just gonna dust me. which is okay. They have not made any pit stops yet, so that's encouraging. Alright, not bad. Looks like... oh, we'll probably be back to almost 10th by the time we get out of the pits here, but that's fine. Use my dash for the RPMs. That way you guys can see all that fun stuff. See how much I'm braking and gassing and all that. We got some fresher tires and locked it up a little bit. That's it, we got some fresher tires, so I should be able to run a little bit harder laps. But I'm not going to, just because I'm going to try and save as much as I can, just make this run in particular last a little bit longer. It's the middle of the race. And I still got to make one more, so if I make this one, I don't know, 8 laps maybe. Man, I really got to pay attention. Yeah, if I can make this one about 8 laps, then... the last run, I think I'll be able to run some harder laps and maybe make up some ground where everyone else might have stayed out or something. So there's a cool glare right in the middle of the screen. Probably should have shifted up there, but that's okay. Yeah, we're on lap 5, so a little bit smoother now. Now I think I might turn the HUD off from here on out to the next race or so. Well, maybe, it's not getting crazy. Maybe when I'm in a NASCAR I'll turn the HUD off, because obviously I don't know, I'm just more familiar with them, so it'd be easier, I think, to just jump into a car on a track with the HUD on. Can't tell if the car on the outside there is poor position or if they're a lap car. Not real sure. I know Denny was right there. I am clear of him. I'm going to say these guys are poor position. They've got some speed. And besides, with the quick stop, I don't think I'd be coming up on lapped traffic. And if they are lap traffic, it's just because they made a pit stop. Does not necessarily mean they are the slow cars on the track. That's pretty smooth there. See, like right now, it's just... oh. I was gonna say, I'm gonna try and keep my nose clean and just tick off some laps here, but I guess I don't mind using the front bumper as long as I don't actually have some damage on it. Yeah, good pass there. Not really sure where the quote-unquote passing zones are here. To me, if you got to run on someone, you can go under them and pass them, but I know some tracks have, like, I don't know if it's designated necessarily, but it's just like the understood. You don't usually pass people here, but I don't know any of those spots. So right there, she left the door open. Take it right there. That car going up the hill was a position. Okay, cool. So we're up to third now. See if I can't slipstream a little bit. Get a run going into this corner. Maybe I can outbrake him. down one too many gears. Nationwide. That's what this video is brought to you by. I really can't see where I'm at. Let's go down. There we go. Try to peek around in. Stuck my nose in. Didn't really have an opening, so I'm not going to force it right now. Or, you know, there's still basically 7 laps left, so. I'm trying to race these guys clean anyway. I don't really enjoy just wrecking everyone out of the way. Looks like he's running the low side there, like he was maybe blocking? I don't know, but that really hosed his exit there. Except now he's gonna booger up my entrance. Okay, we cleared him very easily there. The Doritos bag. The man, the myth, the legend. Pretty easy overtake, really. But you know, I didn't look. I think I cleared him before I just went across the track there. So I've got one more quick stop to make. And we are on lap, I think, 7. There's 15 laps, so basically we've got a little over 7 laps left. So I'm not really afraid of not having the speed, obviously, because we've just tracked down the field, essentially, and passed him back, so. Although, I don't know if he made any quick stops during that time, or what I'm talking about, the Dorito bad guy, the leader. But I'm going to assume they're on the same schedule as me. Much there. Just about lost to get into that corner. Oh man. Cannot get that entrance right for some reason whenever I'm running by myself. Always seem to booger it up just enough. Screw everything else up. Whew. Tried to come around on me. Starting to notice I'm using up a lot more of the track on some of these corners, especially that one there. Yeah, I'm having a harder time holding it down on the carousel. I don't think my entrance is necessarily much worse. I think it is just the tires falling off a little bit. Whoa, that didn't help the grip issue there. Yeah, because we ran, I think it was 3 complete laps. Now we're going on our 4th on these sets of tires. Family's home. You hear a lot of background noise. That's probably what it is. I'll try and keep the background noise to a minimum if I can. I mean, I can't control everything in the house, so I'll just try and mute and cut out stuff. So hopefully it's not too distracting or anything like that. But if I get quiet for, you know, a lap or two, that's why I'm just trying to cut out some excess background noise is all. so I think I'm gonna get one more lap in pit next time around. You guys probably could notice we get a little bit sloppy that last lap. Corners a little bit wider than they should have, locked them up a couple times. Pushing on some corners, it seems like. About lost it, where was that last lap? Oh well, it don't matter. Yeah, tires are definitely going away on me, which is to be expected. So I'm gonna pit next time around. I have no idea how far ahead or close I am to lap traffic, just because of the telemetry that's up, which I guess is part of the fun. But we're definitely gonna pit this time around. Oh yeah, about lost it after the carousel. I thought I could carry a little bit more speed in there, and thought better, and really had to lay on the brakes to scrub some speed off. But due to my expert handling, I didn't have to do that. Right there, obviously I wouldn't normally brake as heavy, but you guys get the point. If I hit the apexes just right, so I don't have to wheel the car quite so much. So obviously that so like right now, not holding it down. Could be a combination of bad entry and, you know, worn tires, but right here is about where I lost it last time. Dove in a little bit extra there. Yeah, doesn't matter. Pretty sloppy actually. But yeah, coming up here, we are gonna do the final pit stop. Change views. I think I'm going for a nose view maybe. Someone got the tires and killed the sign. That's unfortunate. Notice I'm not really shifting up either. Not really trying to save gas necessarily, but yeah, tires are well worn. I'm on 42% fuel. Yeah. Okay, I had almost a mile on second place. Awarded tick. Interesting name. Anyway. So yeah, pretty sure I'll get passed by him. Not worried about third place. I'd say me and the awarded tick are obviously the class of the field. Doesn't look like he's even going to get to us. So, as long as I can just... Okay, here he comes. He may be pitting, though. No, he's definitely not pitting. He's going to have to make another pit stop, so not super duper worried about him. Here he comes, actually. Whoa. Cold tires. Trying not to get up into him. I guess I heat these tires. This video brought to you by McDonald's. Have it your way? No. I'm loving it. There we go. I'm not going to be able to see. There we go. He kind of got out of my way. Almost like he was conceding the spot to me. Except he then... I have no question that I'm faster than him. It's just going to be like getting around him. And I'm not going to force the issue because, like I said, he's got to pit again. And I do not. And there's only two laps left, so it's got to come here soon. Back out. No need to push it and then get in the wall or something stupid. Just because I've got the fastest car does not mean I'm going to win if I put it in the fence, obviously. It's just fast enough. A little bit. Okay, see, that's what I can't do. Trying to race him clean. Not really his fault, that's just... Maybe that's one of those passing zones I was talking about that I didn't know. Maybe that's not one to do that. So he's probably going to pit right here, because he's not going to pit coming out. Yeah. Perfect. Yeah, I just got to keep the car clean and on the track. And that'll be a race there, gentlemen and ladies. I don't even care if I have horribly sloppy corners like that one. I'll take them. Just not gonna hit that corner in this race, I suppose. Good grip in that corner, assuming that's due to the semi-fresh tires. Oh, and I am so excited, you guys, for the actual NASCAR series. That'll be a hoot. Gonna have a NASCAR Revolution. Have a season of that. I don't have the 2017 pass, so some stuff's not going to be quite up to date, but I'm not going to worry about it if you guys aren't. Yeah, I took that corner way faster last time. Or than last time, rather. Yes, I'm not sure what series or track or anything I'm going to do for the next long play, but, I don't normally do, you know, high-class cars. I like old muscle cars, those are fine. I usually stick to A-class and lower, exception being, you know, NASCARs. Alright, here we go for the last lap, and I'll just run this one quiet unless something interesting happens. Best lap, 2 minutes 10.307. We'll see how that stacked up compared to everyone else. Dusted this stuff. Hey, I want to spin. Don't care. Alright. Look at these race results. Alright. Yeah, hands down, fastest. yeah. Anyone have to make more than two stops? Yes. Repair Atomic Toast, 101 Gamer, and Nubbit Slayer. that's fun. Oh, he didn't even finish. What happened there? Did he get total? Too far behind? I don't know. And so the margin of victory was, you know, substantial. Not quite a minute, but pretty good. So yeah, alright, I'll leave it here. Thanks guys for watching. Stick around, we'll have more of these coming up. Stay tuned for just more videos in general. Hope you guys had a good time. I'll catch you guys next time. Bye.